In the physical world, an infrastructure could be made up of such things as roads and bridges, connecting cities and countries. The roads and bridges have rules, or standards, to make them sturdy and usable. They cross borders, but maintain these standards in different geographical regions. A digital version of an infrastructure uses the internet to connect a series of related resources, enabling online research. These digital resources could be the collections in museums, libraries, or universities, which are organized along various subjects. The information is made available online in various ways. It could be through scanned images of documents, or more commonly, through metadata, information about the collection as a whole. Meet Doc Brown. He's back from the future. He is very interested in the history of travel and is particularly curious about the expansion of railways during the First World War. He wants to use a research infrastructure that specialises in this period. For instance, this is Sendari, a research infrastructure that brings together digital archives and resources on the subject of World War I. Doc Brown logs into Sendari and searches the archival directory for information on the topic of railways. Here he can browse collections and decide which archives are most relevant to his topic. Using a digital infrastructure like Sendari gives Doc access to hundreds of resources on the topic of railway travel that can be downloaded, analysed, annotated, and shared with other researchers. Digital infrastructures enable Doc to ask new kinds of questions and use new kinds of tools to look for answers.